Hi, it's Contemporary Phone, day three, sorry, day four, and, you can see it's me, and I'm back. I'm just going to continue on this, that thing. I've read now 115 pages in The Unexplicable Logic of My Life. As I expected, I really like it, I really enjoy it, and it's not dense in a way, but you kind of, I suppose I kind of think I'm reading it slowly in a way, because I'm reading it and lots of the scenes and passages just make me think. So I read a passage and then stop and you think, oh, it's a great way of saying things. And then just ponder on that for a minute or two and then read past. So even though I've been reading for 2 hours now, I've only gotten 115 pages in. Well, I'm sorry, I started reading yesterday, so, but I haven't gotten far into the book, even though I could, because I read fast. Because this book, I think, it's kind of a book that you kind of have to take your time, because there's so much to every word, to every sentence, to every scene, there's so much going on. As I said, I'm 115 pages in, and some books, 115 pages, not that much has happened. Here, a lot has happened. You've been introduced to characters. Well, I suppose I don't know yet how many more characters will show up. It might be that some new will show up. But I got a pretty good feeling and picture of the characters that I have met. You've got a feeling for the setting, for the plots, and it's kind of, I would say anyway, it's kind of a quiet story so far anyway. It's like, not that much has happened. Big thing has happened, but I won't say it because spoilers. Even though it's soon in the book, I don't want to say it. So not a lot has happened. It's very much more about Salvador, or Sal, the protagonist, thinking about his life, thinking about the future, thinking about his past. It's very much thinking. It's not that, if you were to ask me, write down what has happened, it would be like, one or two or three things, but there's still 115 pages, so there's still so much that's been going on. It's not like the rest of the pages are empty, they're just not actions, they're more ideas and thoughts, really. And yeah, it's a really good book so far, really, really good, really liking it. So I'm gonna continue reading, and as I said yesterday, soon, today, my sister's coming, and her kid. So I'm not sure how much I'll be reading when she comes. But I'll be reading when I can. And yeah, of course, sometimes my nephew was sleeping, and it's not like I'll be playing with him all the time. So, yeah, I'm really, really enjoying this book. Update over.
Hey, it's me, Renee. I'm back. So, I finished this one. Yeah, I'm a big fat liar. I told you this day yesterday, and also pretty sure earlier today, in my early update, that I probably maybe wouldn't finish this today, because of my visit from my sister. Yeah, still read it. And like, well, I think sometimes I overestimate how much different aspects will change, because, yeah, I'm having a visit this weekend from my sister, and tomorrow everyone's coming. Like, tomorrow my other sister's coming. I have one left, but two of three are coming. And in the weekend, there's a big party for my nephew. But still, there will still be time to read now and then. It's not like I'll be playing with him all the time. It's not like I'll be social all the time. So I have time to read. And I had time to read today as well. And boy, this book, as you see, all of the notes, so many passages that I love, that's just sitting with me. This is actually going to be a book that I'm going to cherish and think about forever. It's not a book you can forget easily. It's a very, very impactful book, just leaves you in awe of how well it's written, how all the themes it's uses, it discusses, and just everything is just amazing. So yeah, finished this book today. Read 2-3 hours this morning, and then finished the rest of this evening. So there's that. It's now evening here in Norway. It's 5 to 10 in the evening. I don't really think I want to start anything new now. Well, never say never, but I don't think I will. Like, as in tonight, I will start anything new tomorrow. Because the inexplicable logic of my life, it just kind of needs to settle in my body for a bit, in my soul. I don't think I can move on to a new book now. And besides, it's late in the evening, so it's not like I'm going to be up that much anyway. I think I'm going to be up a bit more, just watch YouTube and stuff, and then go to bed, really. And yeah. So yeah, my reading day for today, contemporary, has been a very good day. Very good. Can't complain. Can't complain at all. And my plan, as you would probably assume if you pay attention, is to start this one tomorrow. A Geek's Guide to Unrequited Love by Sarah-Vance Tesh. It's, all the books are contemporary. It's a contemporary readathon. But it's contemporary romance. It's contemporary focused on fandoms. So that's going to be fun. It's shorter than the other two books. I think, yeah, actually, the last two books were actually around 400 pages. And this one is just 250. So yeah, it's half of that one and half of Other Side of Happiness, really. So it's not short, but it's a short book again. So I started short, and then I just went bigger and bigger, and I'm doing so short again. And yeah, so you might have, if you're painting, might have guessed, because tomorrow is Friday and the contemporary readathon goes to Sunday. And as I said, I probably will get more time to read than I initially thought. But I don't know, so I might just be reading this during the weekend. But it's not impossible that I'll finish this tomorrow or Saturday. And if I do that, I'll be reading this one. It's a Norwegian crime book, but it's a contemporary crime, so it fits. Well, I mean, you can't read mystery, because I've seen some people in NTBRs having mystery. So yeah, it's a Norwegian, as you see, crime book. It's, I think it's middle grade of like 10 to 12 year olds. I started slightly yesterday, and it was decent. It wasn't awful. The language is quite simple, but the story and plot is intriguing and fun. So yeah, it's gonna be fun to read this. It's another short book. So yeah, I think that's probably gonna be good. And next week, I'm actually, just a little sneak peek if you paying attention. Next week, I'm actually doing the Gilmore Girls readathon. And that goes actually over 2 weeks, and that starts next Tuesday. So yeah, I think it's going to be fun to end this readathon with two smaller books, really. And yeah, that's my update for contemporary readathon day 3. I hope you had a nice reading day as well. And bye bye, Renee. Thanks.